Hi everyone, this is Jim Egan, head of school, Synapse School with a Friday update. It's May, if you didn't know, it's May. Anyone who's a parent or works in a school knows how incredibly impacted the calendar is in May. Not in bad ways, certainly not at Synapse, but there are so many events going on in May. I think it's just gotten more and more, the calendar's gotten more and more packed over the years. So we have concerts, we have celebrations, we have all kinds of ceremonies that are leading to the end of the school year. So it's super busy, it's a super busy time. Last night, let's start with a few things that are impactful. Last night we had not only a Twilight track meet that I heard was super fun for the kids who ran in the twilight as the sun was going down over in Woodside. We had a board meeting. We also had a Brainwave Learning Center showcase symposium, research symposium, showcasing what we do in the BLC, the devices we're using, the work we're doing with Stanford, the research practice partnership, what that means. The people from Stanford came over. It was a packed house, by the way. But we were also showcasing our middle school research assistants who work directly with our neuroscientists, as well as the Stanford team, the postdocs, the PhDs, and Professor Bruce McCandless. And to hear them speak and articulate what the learning journey has been for them as a BLC research assistant just sort of blew my mind, right? That I could not believe when we started this 5 years ago where we would be at this point. And we've exceeded all of my expectations. If you don't know about the BLC, look it up on our website. You know, contact me, parents. It is a one of a kind. It's the only one in the world. It's a truly unique program that is allowing your students to dive deeply into not only what the brain does and how the brain works, but more importantly, how science works, how you collect data, how you use that curiosity, inquiry, and those skills to make change in whatever you're doing. And that's what happens when they go off to high school and beyond to be the positive change makers that we expect them to be. So that was happening. That was mind blowing. And now we also have exit tickets, so switch gears a little bit, to our eighth graders who are getting ready to leave us for high school. These exit tickets are projects, part project, I should say, as well as part exposition of learning in celebration of their experience at Synapse. So we have a culminating event for each one of these students where they invite teachers, friends, family, to come and hear them explain their project, also their years at Synapse. And then we have the opportunity to tell stories, and most importantly, share love, affection, and praise for them before they go. Those are deep, emotional, vulnerable, funny, meaningful meetings that are going on. They started today, and they'll go on for the rest of the month. I know they are perhaps my number one priority as a head of school, to do whatever I can to make sure I'm not only present, but also emotionally available. And parents of those eighth graders, if you're watching, like, I can't explain it very, very well. It's hard to articulate. You can talk to some parents who've been through the exit tickets, but they are not only important for your kid, they are moving and monumental for the parent and for the family as well. So that's what's happening. They're a big deal. And you know, we have other fun things going on today. Like, we had handstand competition at our assembly today. I've never tried it a handstand. This is true. It's a true story. I've never tried to do a handstand until today, when a few kids, L2 kids, a couple second graders, convinced me to give it a shot against the wall. And I was getting close. I think I'm getting there. It might be a stretch goal for me this summer. Okay, try some handstands. Say hi, come to campus. It's a lot of fun right now to be on Synapse, or at Synapse, and to be the head of school. Okay, take care.